If you are a citizen of Australia or you reside in Australia, this could be one of the most important videos that you will ever watch. There are some secrets that have been kept hidden from us, and now it is time to hear the truth, lest we forget. Honouring our Anzacs and the role they have played in our unified history is an important part of the pathway to actualizing yourself as a self-determined man or woman who has a biblical land claim here in Australia. Thanks to Australia's Prime Minister, Billy Hughes, we were declared a self-determined nation by King George V after the Great War. The Anzac Shrine of Remembrance in Melbourne is sacred land, as are all of the Anzac shrines. The Melbourne Shrine of Remembrance is special. It was funded by the people of Australia for the people of Australia. It is extremely important and significant. On the 11th of November 1934, a quarter of a million people gathered to pay homage to our fallen so that we will always remember. The shrine represents peace, justice, patriotism and sacrifice. The four external statues remind us of that. Within the sacred chamber of the Shrine of Remembrance is the Ark of Covenant, otherwise known as the Ark of God. It is depicted as a gold-coloured wooden box, as described in the Book of Exodus in the Bible. The Book of Exodus gives detailed instructions on how the Ark is to be constructed to protect us from the great flood that lasted 40 days and 40 nights. Genesis 7 verse 12 on the KJV version. And the rain was upon the earth for 40 days and 40 nights. A great flood is upon us. We have been taken off of the land and onto the sea, which is the jurisdiction of the Vatican. The Anzac Shrine of Remembrance tells us how we can come home to the land through the line of authority that takes us out of the jurisdiction of the sea and onto the land that has been laid out before us by our Anzacs, which is God, King, and Country. It is important to note that Australian law has its foundations within the King James Bible. The Australian Constitution 1900 preamble of humbly relying on the blessing of Almighty God have agreed to unite in one indissoluble federal commonwealth under the crown of the United Kingdom of Great Britain and Ireland under the constitution hereby established. Jeremiah 3 verse 16, and it shall come to pass that ye be multiplied and increased in the land, and in those days, saith the Lord, they shall say no more, the Ark of the Covenant of the Lord, neither shall it come to mind, neither shall they remember it, neither shall they visit it, neither shall be done any more. More evidence of the sacred intention of the Anzac Shrine of Remembrance is that on the 11th month of the 11th day at the 11th hour, the planets align to shine the light of God's blessing on the message, greater love hath no man. The term greater love hath no man is derived from the Bible verse John 15. Greater love hath no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. John 15, 13. Often invoked in the context of self-sacrifice, the Anzac Shrine recognizes the sacrifice of our Anzacs and symbolically anchors in our biblical land claim. This symbolically holds the true line of authority, which is God, King, and country, which anchors in our kingdom. Lest we forget. And we did. This was the intention of our de facto foreign occupiers. Symbolically speaking, the Pool of Remembrance was removed in 1951, 3 years after the United Nations were declared our trustee in the Nationality and Citizenship Act. The Pool of Remembrance reminded us to look back and reflect on the sacrifice of our Anzacs. The kangaroo and the emu on the Commonwealth coat of arms, these two animals are unique to Australia and cannot walk backwards, hence Advance Australia Fair. Moving forwards, forgetting the past. A generation of historical deception. As per the treaty in 1939, we had all forgotten who we were. We had forgotten who we were as a people, we had forgotten who we were as a nation, and we had forgotten we were free. Our Anzacs fought for our freedom under the red 1901 federal land flag, and this flag was officially consecrated on Friday, the 31st of July, 2020. A red 1901 federal land flag was raised at every Anzac shrine in every capital city, honouring our Anzacs and the true Australia Day. The 26th of January, the day we think Australia Day is, was actually the day we became an occupied territory in 1910, when the Great White Fleet came to Australia to collect the war debt owed, and we signed 8 Hague War on Land treaties that are still in force now. Australia has been under the rules of war since 1910, but this fact has been hidden from us in plain sight. There seems to be a lot of confusion between the red 1901 federal land flag and the red ensign flag. In Australia specifically, the flag you fly indicates which jurisdiction you are in. When you fly the red ensign flag, you are demonstrating that you are under maritime law, the law of contracts, which is the law of the sea. The red ensign is the correct flag to be displayed by foreign private vessels in the United Kingdom waters. Merchant vessels from British overseas territories and Crown dependencies are entitled to red ensign, defaced with the badge of their territory. When you fly the 1901 federal land flag, that indicates that you know your standing. It indicates that you are a living man or woman who does not identify with the fictitious straw man that your birth certificate connects you to. When you fly the 1901 federal land flag, it indicates that you know your standing. It indicates you are a living man or woman who does not identify with the fictitious straw man that your birth certificate connects you to. In war, your flag tells the enemy who you are. The 1901 federal land flag shows that you are a peaceful civilian who is not part of the foreign occupation. It clearly states that you are protected under the various war treaties such as the Hague, the Nuremberg Code and the Liber Code, to name a few. Knowledge is power, and this knowledge is powerful. The blue and red ensign flag was declared the Australian National Flag in 1953 by way of the Flags Act of 1953. In 1948, all Australians officially left the land and boarded the citizenship, as documented in the Nationality and Citizenship Act of 1948. The United Nations was declared Australia's trustee. We left the imperial realm as imperial subjects of the crown and became citizens. The blue flag, officially declared some 5 years later, proves that we were registered under the symbol. Know your flags. According to the 11th edition of Black's Law Dictionary, a flag is defined as a rectangular piece of cloth, bunting, or other material decorated with a distinctive design and used as a symbol or signal. It is also something symbolized by the display of the flag, such as a ship or nationality. A maritime flag is used on a vessel to show what country the vessel is registered to. The red 1901 federal land flag has a 3-to-2 ratio. Its base color is red, with a Union Jack on the top left-hand corner, which is known as the maritime bow flag. It contains the St. George's Cross of England, the St. Andrew's Cross of Scotland, and the Cross of St. Patrick's of Ireland. Underneath the Union Jack, there is a six-pointed star known as the Merkaba. The word Merkaba comes from a Hebrew word mitz, which means chariot, and when broken down phonetically, means light, body, spirit, from an ancient Egyptian translation. If you consider both meanings, it essentially refers to a way of connecting with light, body, and spirit through the means of this vehicle or symbol. Perhaps it symbolizes our ascension process in a biblical sense, our ark, so to speak. The Southern Cross stars all have a different number of points, indicating constellation significance of their positioning in the sky from a biblical sense. The star closest to the Merkaba has 9 points, and moving clockwise, the stars have 8, 7, 6, and 5 points. The federal ensign flag also has a Union Jack on the top left-hand corner, and it has either a red background, which defines you as a merchant vessel, the blue flag, which defines you as a government corporation vessel, and the white flag indicates that you are a naval vessel. The stars are different. The 7 stars under the Union Jack represent 7 states, and all the other stars have 7 points except the smallest star of the Southern Cross. The United Nations is an unregulated private company who flies a light blue flag with a Gleason's flat earth map from 1892. It is interesting to note that Antarctica is missing and the grid overlaying the map has 33 segments. A laurel wreath frames the world map, which symbolizes the victory of the Roman Empire. Why would a globalist organization put a flat earth map on their flag? The United Nations claim to be a peacekeeping organization, yet their flag states otherwise. Does this appear to be a deception in plain sight? The black flag represents the absence of a flag, and thus stands in opposition to the very notion of nation states. The police, otherwise known as policy enforcers, as they enforce the policies of the foreign occupied de facto government, are now wearing blackened flags. Even the Prime Minister of Australia appears to be wearing a blackened Australian flag. Australia's trustee, the United Nations, have no flags flying at their headquarters in New York. Black flags and no flags at the UN equals the reigning in of a new era of a new world order. When the UN officially move in, you will need to declare who you are and where you stand. If you are a self-determined living man or woman, you will need to fly the 1901 federal land flag. Make it clear that you are not part of the foreign occupation. Their laws do not pertain to you as you are not under their jurisdiction. This is very important. Now, this concludes part 2A of The Truth Will Set You Free. Part 2B will be focusing on the importance of the crown and why you need to know the difference between the imperial crown and the St. Edward's crown. If you'd like to learn more, please visit www.com.au/blog or subscribe to my YouTube channel at Dawn Kelly or visit my backup channel, Fluffy Bunny Angel Unicorn. If you valued this video, then please like and share it with your friends and family. Donations are greatly received and have a blessed day. Thank you.
I come from the dream time, from the dusty red soil plains. I am the ancient heart, the keeper of the flame. I stood upon the rocky shore, I watched the tall ships come. For 40,000 years I've been the first Australian. I came upon the prison ship, bowed down by iron chains. I fought the land, endured the lash, and waited for the rains. I'm a settler, I'm a farmer's wife, on a dry and barren run. A convict, then a free man, I became Australian.
I'm the daughter of a digger who sold the mother lode. The girl became a woman on the long and dusty road. I'm a child of the depression.
I saw the good times come.
I'm a bushy, I'm a battler. I am Australian.
We are one. We are many, and from all the lands on earth we come, we'll share a dream and sing with one voice. I am, you are, we are Australia.
I'm a teller of stories, I'm a singer of songs. I am Albert Namatjira, and I paint the ghostly gowns. I'm Clancy on his horse, I'm Ned Kelly on the run. I'm the one who waltzed Matilda, I am Australian.